Hit the subscribe button, get more updates and push the notification bar.
Good morning everyone, this is Abhishek from Abir Technologies. Abir Technology happens to be a group of teachers who are trying to bring technology to your homes. We are not only providing tutorials for Java but also for Python, HTML and JavaScript and many more. This initiative was taken by me and Mr. Abir only so that those students who cannot afford tuitions do not have to go and seek somewhere else. Rather than they can just subscribe to our channel and like our channel, and they will be able to learn something which can help them in near future. Okay, so today's topic, what we will be looking forward is that the implementation of while loop. Now you must have known that a while loop is an entry control loop in Java along with for, which actually helps us to print structures. So for having more implementation of while loop, one part or one topic which actually comes in our school life or which has troubled us, troubled some kids in our school life, is the digit extraction. So let's see what digit extraction means. Okay, as you can see, my editor is already open. I am using Java NetBeans. Anyone can use anything, any other IDE as well. I'll prefer BlueJ because BlueJ is actually a better IDE for learning than NetBeans. But it's okay, but we will try today to do it with the NetBeans. Okay, so we know very well how to create a project. So this is in MacBook. You can use Windows as well. In Windows, you click the new project button. There is this, you'll get the categories in which what you want from Java. The top category, that is Java, we are going to select this one. And then the projects, in the projects we can see we have a Java application, Java class library, project with existing sources and Java freeform project. As we are not dealing with anything else, we'll just simply click on the Java application and click on the next button. Okay, now as you can see, the project name has been asked, so we have to give a name to this project. So let's give the name as digit extraction, because that is going to be more specific mnemonics for us. For all those who have just logged on to this channel, please hit the like and the subscribe button and make sure that this great initiative taken by us reaches to maximum number of students, those students who do not have the privilege to afford tuitions. Okay, let's click the finish button. As you can see, a new package of digit extraction has been created and a class named digit extraction also exists. So what we are trying to do is we will try to understand this concept. Okay, now we know that this happens to be this backslash and the double star are multi-line comments. Okay, multi-line comments, and you can see that over here it has been written that at param args, that's args, the command line arguments, but you can write anything else as well over here. This happens to be a single line comment, this double slash. Okay, so let's write some code which will help us to understand that what this program is all about. Okay, what is digit extraction? Okay, digit extraction means that we are going to input that we will input a number and print its digits. As you know very well, suppose a number has been given to you, right? Example 529. Okay, so what we will try to do is we are going to print 9, 2 and 5 in separate lines. Why this topic is important? Because normally in English medium schools, mostly in ICSE and in the West Bengal board also schools, those who have Java, many a times program comes, write a program to input a number and print the sum of its digits, write a program to input a number and print those digits that are divisible by 5. So we will see the two major uses of this thing. First, the use of the while loop, and second, the use of the modulus operator. As you know, modulus operator is used to find the remainder of a number, right? For example, if I say 25 modulus 4, this will give us what? This will give us 1, right? So we'll see that how we are going to implement this in our program. Okay, let's take a number, say int n equal to 529, and let's take somewhere where you can store this remainder. For example, rem equal to 0. So what we will do is we will extract each digits and we will show how the while loop actually happens. Now, while loop is an entry control loop, which means what? Which means that this condition that we will place in while will control the number of iterations that it happens. Iteration means each time a loop runs. So let's face it, while n not equal to 0. Rem equal to n modulus 10. System.out.println. The digit is 10 equal to 10 slash. Let's first print this number as well. This will help us, you know, to understand that what the number initially was. Alright, there you go. Okay. Now, before we explain each line, let's see what our output is. Okay, so let's start with the run. As you see, there is a run button over here, right? We can use this one, or we can click on the right click button and there will be this run file option. Okay, but before that, let's save this program. You can save it using Control S, or you can go to the file menu and you will see this save as. Okay, so let's save this. As you can see, we have saved it as digitextraction.java. okay, now let's run this file. What happens? Okay. As you see, the number is 529, which we have printed the number. First the digit is 9, next the digit is 2, next the digit is 5. As you can see, the build is successful. Okay. Now let's see what we have actually done in this program. Okay. Okay. Let's start with this line. Okay. Int rem equal to 0. What we are trying to do over here is, you can give this 0 or you may not give this 0. It doesn't work, but it is better to initialize it with some value so that no garbage value by default enters into our program. Many a times different compilers store garbage values inside your newly declared variables. Now moving on to this condition, while in not equal to 0, what we are trying to do, okay? We are first trying to divide this number with 10. As you know very well that n is an integer, right? So what happens when an integer is divided with another integer? As you understand that this means that whenever an integer is divided by another integer, a decimal point value may or may not arise depending on whether the number is fully divisible or not. If the number is fully divisible, then there will be no remainder. But if the number is not divisible, what happens then? The entire part of it gets stored in the number. For example, if I say 45 is divided by 10, right? And I'm trying to store it in an entire value, like say int c is equal to 45 by 10. What do you think will happen? The number that will get stored in c is nothing but 4. Why? Because if you divide 45 by 10, you will get 4.5 in the normal mathematical integer division. But because, you know, we have declared it an integer and it cannot hold any, you know, floating point values, as you know, integer happens to be lower order than float in the operator precedence, hence only the integer part will get stored in the number. So we are basically using this same technique, you know, to extract the digits. All right. So what happens when we divide 529 divided by 10? The number 52 gets stored in n in the first iteration. So n becomes 52. Consequently, again, if the loop runs, and we know very well, since 52 is not equal to 0, again, this code, for the moment, let's skip these two lines. For the moment, let's skip these two lines. Again, this number will go over here, and over there again the new value of n, that is equal to 52 divided by 10, will get stored in the n in the second iteration. That is nothing but 5. In the third iteration, what happens? 5 is not equal to 0 in the while loop, which means the while loop will again run, and after skipping these two lines, we get n equal to 5 by 10. So n becomes 5 by 10, which means this time n will have the value as 0. So basically what we are trying to do is, we are trying to reduce the number to 0 itself. Okay. Now when the number is, you know, reduced to 0, this while loop breaks and we are left with the numbers. Okay. Now let's see what happens in this part. Okay. Our number in the first iteration, okay, is 529. When I do it modulus 10, when I divide it by 10, right? If you do it in maths, okay. So what is the remainder that you are going to get? You'll be getting 9 as a remainder. And this remainder is getting stored in RAM. In the first iteration. Now in the second iteration, and okay, before moving on to the second iteration, we are understanding that when this 9 is getting stored in the RAM, we are trying to print the 9, right? System.out.println, that is the digit is 9. So hence the first output was that the digit was 9. In the second iteration, as you see, the RAM is nothing but 552 divided by modulus 10, and it stores 2 as a remainder. Why? Because when I divide 52 with 10, the remainder is 2. Okay, so the next part that it gets printed is 2. Finally, the third iteration. In the third iteration, RAM becomes 5 modulus 10. Okay, why 5 now? This you guys have to understand. Okay, whenever this is not division, first of all, this is not division. Whenever you are dividing 5 with 10, okay, we know what 10 into 0 is 0, right? Because 5 will not be divided by 10 directly. So when you are writing it 5 divided by 10 and 10 0 gives 0, what is the remainder left with? Is nothing but 5. Okay. So this is how we see the digit extraction program. Now let's see how this digit extraction program actually is utilized in the next upcoming videos. Till then, subscribe to our channel, like it, please share it so that others can, you know, also get benefited from this video.
যদি ভিডিওটি আপনাদের ভালো লাগে তাহলে প্লিজ চ্যানেলটিকে লাইক শেয়ার এবং সাবস্ক্রাইব করবেন। আপডেট সবার আগে পাওয়ার জন্য অবশ্যই বেল আইকনে ক্লিক করবেন। ধন্যবাদ।